You and your attorney are ready for trial, your medical malpractice trial. And now, when the defense attorney is asked by the judge whether he's ready for trial, he says, no, judge, I'm not. Are there any repercussions for the defense attorney saying, listen, judge, I'm not ready for trial? You want to know the answer? Come join me on this walk through the neighborhood as I share with you the answer to this question. Hi, I'm Jerry Ojinski. I'm a New York medical malpractice and personal injury attorney. All right, so let's say you sued your doctor for medical malpractice, claiming that he was negligent, that he was careless, and caused you significant harm and injury. And now, after 2 years, your case is finally coming up for trial, or at least you think it's coming up for trial. You know your case has been sitting on the trial calendar for months and months, and now your attorney has told you he's going into court for a pretrial settlement conference. This is not the first time you're going in for a conference, or I should say, your attorneys are going in for a conference. So now your attorney goes into court, the defense attorney is there, they meet with the judge turns to the attorneys and says, counselors, are you able to settle this case before I send you out for trial? And now we have all sorts of excuses from the defense as to why they have not been able to offer money on this case. The judge says, fine. He turns to me and says, counselor, are you ready for trial? I say, judge, I'm ready. My client is ready. My experts are lined up and ready to go. You just say the word and we're all set. He then turns to the defense attorney and says, counselor, are you ready for trial? The defense attorney looks at the judge and says, no, judge, I'm not. I have another case scheduled for trial. My expert is unavailable at this particular time. I'm not ready for trial. Are there any repercussions? Because the defense attorney now turns around and says, no, I'm not ready for trial. The answer is, there might be. Okay, and I say there might be because the judge might be lenient and understand and accept these particular excuses that are being given by the defense lawyer. He may understand that, listen, this guy has another trial to attend to before this particular one, or he may be away on vacation, or his expert may be unavailable, and these may actually be valid excuses why the judge is not going to force him to go out to trial that particular day or soon after. On the other hand, the judge may turn around and not be sympathetic and say, counselor, you had plenty of time to make all these arrangements. You failed to do that. I told you the last time you were here that if this case does not settle, you're going to go pick a jury right now. So, I don't understand what you've done here. The fact that your expert is unavailable is of no importance to me at this moment. You guys were warned, I told you about it, and yet you still refused to go ahead and prepare this case for trial. In that instance, there is the possibility that the judge could turn to both attorneys and say, go out and pick a jury right now. Tell the jury clerk you guys are ready. I sent you down. Go pick a jury. What happens in that instance? Well, I'll tell you, it's going to be a significant disadvantage to the attorney who is not ready for trial. Typically, the court will give us some advance warning as to when we are scheduled to go ahead and actually try your case. We have to get our experts lined up. We have to get subpoenas sent out. We have to tell our witnesses when they are supposed to be in court. If the judge springs it on us the day before, now we've got a problem. For both sides, we have a scheduling problem. Because I don't know whether all of my witnesses are actually available in the coming days. I have to make phone calls and I have to ascertain whether or not they're ready. I have to determine whether or not all of our medical records that we've subpoenaed into court are in court and ready to go. If they're not, now we may have a problem getting those records into court on time. And I may have to ask the trial judge for additional time simply because I need certain medical records in order to proceed forward. My opponent, who has told the court that he is not ready, is going to be at an even worse disadvantage, if that's even proper grammar or proper English. So why do I say that? I say that because in all likelihood, the doctor whom you have sued is likely not going to be available for trial or not be available at that particular time. His expert, the defense's medical expert, may not be available. Now, again, how do you go to trial if your expert is not available? Well, from a plaintiff's standpoint, from an injured patient's standpoint, it's impossible because these medical malpractice cases actually require us to have a medical expert in order to prove our case. And if we don't have a medical expert to support our case, then guess what? After we're done putting on all of our proof, the judge will dismiss our case because the defense lawyer will say, judge, he hasn't put on a medical expert to support his case. I ask that you throw out the case. And you know what the judge will do? He's going to throw out the case. Why? Because we are required to have a medical expert. So let's get back to the topic I raised in the title of this video. Are there any repercussions for an attorney, a defense attorney, who says they're not ready? The answer is maybe. There may be repercussions. Now, The judge may be doing this. He may push us out to trial in a specific effort to try and get us to settle or negotiate. When the defense realizes that they have no choice but to go to trial and to listen to the gardener with their leaf blowers in the background, now you have to try and go to a quieter place to shoot some video. So if the defense attorney is unable to proceed forward, and he knows that, and the judge knows it, now in an effort to put pressure on him to try and settle this case, he may force us out to trial. Now the defense attorney has no other option but to call the insurance company and say, listen, the judge is forcing me to go to trial. Our expert's not available. Our doctor's not available. I need you to put money up on this case to settle this case. So can it happen? Will it happen? The answer is you don't know until you're actually in the middle of it. And now the defense attorney goes out to make a phone call. So why do I share this quick information with you? I share it with you because it's a beautiful day today here in Great Neck, and I had a few minutes to share some terrific information. You know, I do realize that if you have questions or concerns about your own matter, and you have not yet started a lawsuit, what I invite you to do is pick up the phone and call me. You know, I answer questions like yours every single day, and I'd love to talk to you. You can reach me at 516-487-8207, or by email at Jerry, G-E-R-R-Y, at Ojinsky-Law.com. That's it for today's video. I'm Jerry Ojinsky. Have a wonderful day.